out a new sponsor, the Health Blaze. All the information is in the description. Use the promo code above. Goodfella One Boxing, 18% off of all their natural products from deodorant, pomade, toothpaste, and much, much more. And they have additional discounts on their website as well. That's thehealthblaze.com. Starting December 20th. That promo code is good for 18% off. We go.
All right, man, we back. Goodfella Sports TV. Appreciate everybody for checking in. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, bell icon button. Won't miss another video. And it appears that, Premier Boxing Champions is going to send one of their welterweights to go try to get, be the number one contender in the mandatory for one of Terence Bud Crawford belts. And it is Sergey Lipinets. He's ranked number 4 by the WBO, I believe. The mean machine is number 1, all right? Crawford is rumored to fight him. He said he ain't talked to nobody yet about who he gonna fight or nothing, but it's rumored he gonna take that mandatory out in October, and the only thing that could save him is a suspense fight from that mandatory, so he supposed to be fighting back in Nebraska at the crib or close to the crib, maybe Lincoln, maybe Omaha, I think is where he's from, but also Danny Garcia is ranked right ahead, Lipinets at number 3, and Danny Garcia don't have a fight partner as well. Mikey Garcia sound like he going to the zone, and you know Danny Garcia could fight Terence Crawford right now. You know they could fight in October, push it back to December, do the pay per view on ESPN, let them front the budget, and do it that way. But at the end of the day, like Danny Garcia said right before the Pacquiao fight, he want to fight the winner between Errol and Sean, or the winner of Pacquiao and Keith Thurman, which is Manny Pacquiao, and. You know, he would been in negotiation to fight Pacquiao when he was at Top Rank. Him and Adrian Broner, they got lowballed. And, you know, so that is what it was. But, you know, he don't want to fight Bud. He was criticizing Bud to vilify media, you know, saying that his 140-pound run was better than Crawford's, which I agree, you know, as far as the level of opponents. But Crawford got all the belts, and he unified, you know. And, you know, he said he didn't understand why he wasn't pound for pound. He said if Bud get a belt at 47, then he the best, and he can't dispute that. But let's see if he can get a belt up there, which Bud Crawford did get a belt. But Danny Garcia never wanted to fight him. You know, they tried to go around Al Haymon because Al Haymon, they felt, was freezing out Bud Crawford. They tried to go right to Angel and make a fight, gave an offer. They remained loyal to Al. And, you know, it is what it is. So Danny Garcia obviously don't want that smoke. You know, his daddy boasts about they beat Crawford in the amateurs, and when Crawford beat them, it was just called the runner-up. It wasn't a real loss. But, like I said, man, just go ahead and say y'all don't want the fight. But, you know, Lipinets has expressed that he wanted to fight, I think, Crawford before, if I'm not mistaken. He had a mandatory shot versus Ndongo. And he was a mandatory, and the IBF gave Ndongo exception to fight Crawford for undisputed at 140. So Lipinets had to wait. Now, when Crawford had all the belts, Lipinets kind of shut up and waited till he released the belt, fought Okondo. And really, a lot of people thought Okondo beat Lipinets that fight. Lipinets is a hot, cold fighter. All right? Lipinets would have beat Mikey Garcia. He had the jab. He had the power. He may not just had the world, just the boxing experience. Forget world championship level experience. But the problem with Lipinets, he going to have with a guy like Crawford, and he had with Mikey, is that he just don't have the feet. You know, and he was a kickboxer. And those kickboxers like him, Dillian White, Jarrell Miller, they just don't have the feet. Imagine if Lipinets had the feet to kind of be, you know, the fleet of foot, get on his toes, or just had the coordination like Errol to cut the ring off. And imagine how hard he'd punch. You could just tell Lipinets a natural puncher. Because a lot of kickboxers don't generate that power that Lipinets do. Dillian White, he ain't really a big puncher. Jarrell Miller really ain't a big puncher. Chris Algieri, another guy who was a kickboxer, whatever he was, he didn't generate that power. If Lipinets really got his footwork together, and Joe Goosen, or when he was with Buddy McGurk, had they got his footwork together and really worked on his base and really worked on moving back and forth, you know, side to side, and kind of a little bit of hip movement, kind of slipping a little bit more. I think his head movement is decent. You know, Lipinets might be the best at 147. He might have conquered. He would definitely, if he had the footwork, he definitely would have conquered Mikey. Go look at my prediction video. The only reason I didn't pick Lipinets when I watched the film is because his footwork wasn't up to speed. I ain't just talking about foot speed. I'm just talking about just, you know, able to close the distance. I'm going to cut the ring off, close the distance,
the lateral movement, the in and out movement. He just don't look comfortable. He looked like a natural kickboxer doing those things. And if he don't improve those things, he ain't got no shot versus a guy like Terence. Even a guy like Earl, if he just wanted, he just felt that Lipinets punched too hard, he could just put that 72-inch reach in his face and just use the ring. And you see with Lipinets versus guys like Bonet, he was able to use the ring and outbox Lipinets. He lost that fight. Even Corey Lee said he thought he lost the majority of those rounds. He got a give decision. He came back versus Lamont Peterson, who just refused to box guys like that, who got more power than him, like Earl and Lipinets. He able to beat a guy like that. But if you got a guy that got lateral movement in and out, fluidity upstairs, or just know how to use the ring, Lipinets is just going to get beat to a pulp. But Lipinets is a really strong fighter. It's just the footwork, man. He had footwork, man. I'll give him a huge shot to beat Bud. I think he got a shot because he can punch. He definitely can punch. He got a really nice straight jab. He was schooled by Buddy McGirt for a minute. Now he with Joe Goosen. He's a good coach. So, you know, they understand the deficiencies, but they should need to work on that footwork. But, you know, somebody else called this out before he fought for this Intercontinental belt. And they told me before this fight even happened that, you know, Top Rank was lining Lipinets up for Terence Crawford, one of my subs, and I didn't pay no attention. And then we went on live after the Pacquiao-Thurman fight when Pacquiao won, and Dr. Blick said it's the same belt they put on Anthony Yard, the Intercontinental belt they put on Lipinets before he got his mandatory shot at Kovalev. So, like, I'm really hearing that, you know, maybe they sending Lipinets over there to get the job done. And I don't think that's a bad candidate. You know, me personally, I would have sent somebody else over there first to soften him up in October. They got so many welterweights, they could have sacrificed Berto, which he ain't got no chance to waste the money. Victor Ortiz, John Molina, even though he had a back injury. Your Dennis Yugas. I mean, he just fought, though. Jamal James, he just fought. A lot of their welterweights is all fighting now. You know, Sean Porter, Keith Thurman just fought. Manny Pacquiao, Errol Spence just fought. But they got so many welterweights, you can't even keep track. Josito Lopez, you know, they should have sent him over there in October. Then he could have turned around. Well, let him get his mandatory out the way. What they could do, get his mandatory out the way. If Bud wants to squeeze another fight in December, January, February, send somebody else over there. Because send Josito Lopez over there, you know, since Danny Garcia refused to go. And then I would do Lipinets to keep him occupied and get Lipinets as a mandatory. Try to win the purse bid and get the fight over to PBC. And see what we can do with that fight. But yeah, I think it's a good fight, you know. Lipinets is a little bit more seasoned. Definitely got, you know, good power, understand how to fight southpaws, know how to fight orthodox fighters. So it's something I'm interested in. I think that's a good fight. I think that's the right candidate to send over there. You got a guy that got a lot of power in his hands, and when you got power, you got a good corner like he got with Joe Goosen. Anything can happen. That's what happened to Andy Ruiz. He got power. He has speed in this case. And he had a really good game plan. So, you know, if Lipinets can go up there and knock out Crawford to beat Crawford, which I think if he beat him, it got to be by knockout. Then, you know, at the end of the day, PBC claim another belt. And then undisputed is for Errol Spence, you know, as long as they can get that Pacquiao belt or somehow get that in one, you know, get that in Errol Spence's hands, then undisputed is just that far, not that far away. But right now on the PBC side, I feel that, you know, it's a step back with Manny Pacquiao getting the Super WBA belt, in my opinion, unless he going to fight Errol Spence next, which I think he going to fight Pacquiao, Matt Mayweather next. And if he don't fight Mayweather, then it might be Amir Khan or Danny Garcia. So, you know, if he don't fight Earl, then, you know, really how Earl going to become undisputed. But, I mean, we shall see, man. We shall see. But Lipinets is a good guy to send over there. I would have softened him up a bit before I send Lipinets over there, man. But it is what it is. Lipinets got the power to put any welterweight out if he hit clean. But the problem with him is his foot speed. And Bud like to take chances. So Lipinets going to have a chance. But if Bud come out there on some Victor Postal shit, you know, and he start moving around and out boxing him, Lipinets going to have a hard time getting that timing down pat, especially if he's switching. But, you know, if Bud sit there and exchange with him and he feel like he beat the hope out of Lipinets, And Lipinets get to sitting there like Felix Diaz, he able to shoot some overhand rights or land some left hooks like, you know, Diaz was. If Lipinets can land that shot, he could hurt a lot of guys, including Terence Crawford. So it's a good fight. It's a fight that I'm interested in. And hopefully they extend that Olive Leach branch over to Crawford and they can make this fight down the line. I feel that PBC gonna try to win that purse bid and get Bud over there. That's just how I feel. But hey, don't forget to check out our sponsor out, the Hellblaze, thehellblaze.com. Promo code GoodFellowUnboxing. Get you 18% off the 100% all natural products, lotion, soaps, foot soaks, bath bombs, deodorant, toothpaste, hair palm, much, much more. Website, promo code description. Don't forget we on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Reach out to the email. All those links in the description. Appreciate the love, support. If you want to make a donation, share the video. Donation link in the description. Intro instrumental link in the description as well, too. One time for the one time.